Hello, I'm Wendy Davis. My father, Jerry Russell, founded Stage West Theater in Fort Worth, Texas. My dad was a jack of all trades. He was a brilliant man, excelling in a wide variety of jobs. But his passion for theater was always underneath it all. In 1979, he took a leap of faith and made a massive career change. And soon after, Stage West was born. This theater represents an investment in our Texas culture. We all have a story, we all have a voice, and together we all are represented on the stage of this theater. And its location in the near Southside district of Fort Worth has made it a catalyst for growth and economic development in an area which, for many decades, was largely forgotten. That's the value in community arts, in public works. We all can contribute to this discovery. We can all lead our communities forward to success, and we can all be powerful catalysts for change in this world. Over the last 35 years, this theater has employed thousands of local technicians and artists. Its outreach and educational programs have educated and inspired tens of thousands of Texas children. Its programming in general has been seen by well over 500,000 people. And now, as this neighborhood continues its rebirth, a new generation of patrons and residents are finding out what my father left behind here for them. His final gift, his legacy, is now ours. My father lives on with Stage West. Through every act, every scene, every bow, they resonate with his passion and commitment. This theater will continue to shine as an artistic and cultural gem for our region's community and her visitors for generations to come. It is the beautiful, dynamic, and lasting legacy of my dad, Jerry Russell. Thank you.
Do we need to do it again, the whole thing? Or
can we do it one more time just for safety?
All right.
Stand by.
What I love about Stage West is the sense of community. It's a theater built and operated by theater professionals and serving the North Central Texas area. It's designed to provide entertaining, inspirational, and engaging plays to enrich the lives of residents of the Fort Worth-Dallas area and beyond.
Stage West is dramas and comedies, contemporary and classic. It's annual theater festivals which introduce new works. It's educational opportunities that give people of every age a chance to hone their skills and study many aspects of the art form. All at the highest professional standards.
We were founded in 1979 with the intent to produce works ranging from the beautiful to the bizarre. From thought-provoking to just plain fun. Since that time, over 600,000 people have been served by Stage West, and the number keeps climbing.
Our mission is to produce theater that entertains, inspires, and engages. Our focus is the community. It's husbands and wives, girlfriends and boyfriends, families, neighbors, from all cultural and economic backgrounds.
Come find yourself at Stage West. It's designed for you.
There was no professional
other than, like, Casa Mañana, that's all Billboard wax. There were a lot of good actors in the area that were basically working only at community theater. And my feeling was that if you could really take the good ones, the real good ones, and pay them something, then you could maybe start to create a quality of theater that was higher than people were used to, at least in performance.
Something has to happen to indicate that I got those numbers. That's all.
Why?
I'm saying.
You're already looking at numbers.
I know that, but
okay,
we'll
okay.
see. We'll
I'll
do
give
it.
It to you.
We'll
Fine.
Do it. You'll see.
Wait, let me find the right thing.
It doesn't have to.
I
be
don't
the
have
right.
the right thing.
It doesn't
You're
going to
get
right
this week's
thing.
Ad time box.
Here, you can give me this one. I don't care.
He can probably see what that one says.
I doubt it.
You know what? This all might just be just.
Just
enough.
Use it. Just fucking use it. I swear to God.
And then give me that one. What? Are you rolling?
He's been rolling all along.
Yeah.
He got all of that.
Lovely. What is this? What is this? One spot in Cleveland, one in Cincinnati? Why?
You see the polls?
Well, that line always, I don't know why, that line always sneaks up on me and I forget the next one. Happens every time we run the scene.
Sandwich shop downtown. That's what I was doing at the time. And I built, we did everything. We built all the lights out of coffee cans, and he built a light board, a little dimmer board that had six dimmers on it, just household dimmers, I suppose, that had little, he had built in a board with little rollers. But that's what it was. That's what started the theater. It was $1,100 on my MasterCard.
Il y avait des temps, je ne m'étais pas servi de mes dents. Je n'étais pas de vin dans mon eau, ni de charbon dans mon fourneau.
There was nothing downtown tonight. I mean, nothing. We were the only show down there. The streets were rolled up after 5 o'clock. And I was pretty foolhardy, I think, or naive, because I started the theater and we were doing Zoo Story, which was sort of like a preview to the season. But I announced a whole season and offered season tickets, and we rented a little storefront next to the sandwich shop. And that's where we did the Zoo Story. And Joe Berryman and I did the show. I directed it. I played Jerry. He did Peter. He's the one who built the light board. And my wife, Susie, ran the lights inside. We had a very, very simple set. Mark Walker did some stuff for us. And we had 60 or 70 scenes. We ran it for 5 weekends, 15 performances. and it got rave reviews. We sold 75 season tickets. Obvious that the little space was not going to be enough space. In that 5 weeks of Zeus Story, we played to a total of 275 people. The next show we did was a little show called Rattle the Simple Man. We played to 550. The championship season. We played to 1,100 people. I know all this because it just kept doubling. And then the next show we did was Jacques Brel's Live and Well and Living in Paris. And that put us on. The Norman Conquest, the trilogy. It was just very naive that, you know, it didn't matter. I tackled anything. We still do in a way. And that's all about the entire world. And then we were on our way. And as I told you, we started in the fall of 1970. January of 81, we became a nonprofit organization. And at that point, everything that I had put into it, I gave to the organization. So I gave it. And I was hired for $5,000 a year, which I worked at for about 10 years at that level. And we moved here. Day weekend of 1981. So that was the end of May. And everything that we did in here at that time, we did ourselves. We did all of it. There was no outside contractor, so we did everything. I mean, everything in this place, which was an old abandoned bus garage with nasty, nasty bathrooms and a couple of them. Oh, I remember Quentin Bauer and I ripped those things out, trying to clean up those bathrooms and make them real, build dressing rooms. It was crazy.
We always move into the theater on Monday. We have 3 days in the theater generally. Each day, you know, it's still pretty rough when we first move in here. I mean, they had been working for, this is a fast turnaround this time. They, because we had that New Year's Eve event, they couldn't start building until after that. So they did all this in 9 days. I mean, we had a full week of rehearsal still out there. And we moved on the set Monday night, and that rehearsal, even though you go through the whole show, work out all the set changes and who was moving what when and all of that, you know, and it was 11:45 before we finished that Monday night run. And then each day gets there, and still, you know, it still wasn't done. The floor, in fact, didn't get painted until today. That's always the last thing to do. It's like, so tonight's first night, we really see the show in its entirety. First time.
Ne me quitte pas. Il faut oublier tout. votre soulier qui s'enfuit déjà. Oubliez le temps des malentendus et le temps perdu à savoir comment. Oubliez ces heures qui tuaient parfois à coup de pourquoi. Le cœur du bonheur ne me quitte pas, ne me quitte pas, ne me quitte pas, ne me quitte pas.
Over the course of a year, every year, we put a great deal of effort into the selection of material that we do. And hopefully that selection is somehow aimed at the betterment of the audience's mind, heart, intellect. Allow people to aspire to something greater, something larger, something better, something more meaningful. And I think if you can do that, then you obviously create a better world. Certainly, I will never forget the success of the first job program. So much so that we've done it twice again since then. And still, it even now still touches audiences. It really gets to people. I love that show. There's too many. You know, we've done almost 300 plays now. And there are so many of them. The real thing, Tom Stoppard play, as a director, was one of my all-time favorites. And I always remember that way. 3 Penny Opera. Angels in America. Very ambitious, very daring. And we did both parts of Angels in America. I mean, that's just adventuresome because it's such an epic undertaking of doing both plays that all interconnect with each other, and we've done it. I am especially proud of the August Wilson plays that I directed because here I was, a white director, a white man, directing black actors in a very, very Afrocentric play. Two Trains Running. Joe Turner's Come and Gone. And Fences. Very much their experience, but that I could share that experience and be part of the creative process of telling that story. It made a great many friends that I might not have made otherwise. I love those plays, and I loved what we did with them. There's many things, but I will tell you, and I've said this time and again, and everyone will bear that out, that there's one role that I could have played for years and never gotten tired of it, and that was George, and I was afraid of Virginia. Those rare times that I could not wait to get on the stage every night. Couldn't wait to start the show every night. It was so exciting just to do it. Easily could have run that show for a year and never gotten tired of it. I said I could have run forever. Truly, we run shows. Now we do 20, 24 performances. But that wasn't enough for that show. Could have done it forever. Just could have kept on.
Parfois, du bout des yeux, même riches, ils sont pauvres, ils n'ont plus d'illusions et n'ont qu'un cœur pour deux.
But no less do I love this show that we're doing now. Great cast, love the script, love what it's doing to audiences and how it's affecting. We've not done well with the critics in the show, and yet people, each night, are coming out of the show saying, oh my god, that's just the best show I've ever seen, or, and they're all ages too, I mean it crosses, some people, this is the kind of play that some people are going to hate, and some people are going to absolutely love, and some people are going to be ambivalent about. It's not going to be universal, but when you have people come out, and a 50-year-old man the other night stopped me at an intermission and say, this is the most engaging play I've ever seen. Had a young woman last weekend, mid-30s, maybe even late-30s. She was here with her husband, and they'd taken her mother, to see play. She'd obviously seen some theater, but she sought me out when she found out I was the director afterwards. She saw me out with Bobby, and she said, this is the best play I have ever seen in Fort Worth. And her mother, she introduced me, and the old lady was just beaming. 70, maybe. It was her first play. And she loved it. Loved it. So you get that kind of response. You get that kind of response from the audience members who come out and say, what a wonderful production, what a great cast. And then you get the critics on the other side of it. There's a special bonding that happens. connection and love that lives on, that mental bond that you shared in that creative process and going through the experience of bringing that to the stage and sharing it with an audience. For years, you always had that connection. It's, I guess it's what all of us who work in this field keep doing it for. Because it satisfies something in here that nothing else can buy. Nothing can buy. The community of your fellow artists that you work with, that you share those experiences with, there isn't. It's not easy. Sometimes it's really soul-searching and painful to travel through that exploration and try to finally get what you see or what the audience sees on the stage. It's a great thing.
Uh-huh. Except we are going to have to
redo the line. Because
redo it.
There is not one where she said 5 minutes until airtime.
I always said
she constantly said 5 minutes to airtime.
So
I figured if that happens, we could just make it.
That's fine. But yeah, so we just change it in your script, you know, so that it matches. Since you've made the recording, now you know how to make the adjustments to match the recording.
Once you decide,
you'll have to get a copy of that and listen to it in the car all the time. You know,
we'll get Ashley to do it.
So, as far as plans for the future, I look forward, hopefully within a year, of stepping aside again as far as the management of the theater and staying involved as a director and an actor as long as I can. My dying day.
If we only have love, then tomorrow will dawn, and the days of our years will
we remember before you this day, our brother Jerry. We gather tonight to remember this beloved man back into our presence now.
Jerry would come in from the back of the theater, walk down the aisle, and stand right over there. And then he'd say, "I've been to the zoo." And those five words started his great and excellent adventure. I am sure there are theaters in heaven. I mean, there wouldn't be heaven without it. If there's not, he'll start one.
He was daring to do something that required a huge amount of passion and intelligence and artistry and effort, God knows. And he was willing to take that kind of risk in the midst of that process. Well, from the beginning, I think Stage West was about doing things nobody else was doing. He was a great artist. No one's going to find his work in their attic in 150 years and sell it for millions of dollars. Theater's all about impermanence, but he was.
We were rehearsing in the front room, but let me also, as an aside here, just add that whatever success I've attained as an actor is almost solely due to what I learned at Stage West working with Jerry and with Jim Coppola. I say that flat out. So I put a note up on the bulletin board that said, guys, I can't go, so whoever wants my ticket can have it. Jerry called me. He said, "It's early in the rehearsal process, just tell him you have a conflict and you can go to the game." I said, "I can't believe the producer, director, founder of Stage West is telling me to skip rehearsal to go to a baseball game." He said, "Hell, I do it all the time."
In each city that we lived, his first mission was always to seek out the community theater and get involved. I think he did the Music Man in literally every city we ever lived in. I started waiting tables there at night when the sandwich shop was transformed to a pre-show dinner service when I was about 17 years old, and I waited tables there at night for around 5 years. It was hard, low-paying work, but I wouldn't have traded a second of it because I got to spend all that time with my dad again. I loved that time. I got to see him do so many wonderful things there. If we became anything at all, we owe it to our father. He was magnificent. He was magic.
She's been here 6 times on this production. In fact, this is the first show of our 4th season, and we started out with a goal of 600 season ticket holders, and right now we stand at 828. It might be because we have such a dynamite season. It might be because we're such wonderful people around here. It might be because 3,400 people have seen this show. But it might be because we priced them too cheap, which is what I think is the problem. it's almost incomprehensible to us, but that's the kind of run that it's been. I think you can gather that we hate to see it go away. We're just really delighted to share it with you one last time. It is 25 different shows. Because Brel did not just write songs, he told stories. Some of them will hit you right between the eyes. We hope all of them hit you between the eyes. And we're just real pleased to share it one last time with you. Thank you for being here.
Jesus, I love this country.